influence, the pressure from all this external forces, which tells us that everything is so bad and everything, everybody is out to get you type of stuff. Very important. Never try to get even with your enemies. It doesn't always feel good. I mean, sometimes if you really best someone who is an absolute, you know, bad person or something like that, you know, the point is, I guess the word here is try. Never try to get even with your enemies. Sometimes that happens, you know. So, number three, expect ingratitude. That's important. Expect ingratitude. Don't believe just because you do something that's really awesome and you know it's awesome and you know it's cool and you know it's a good thing, don't expect people to just start brown nosing. You know what I mean? Don't expect that, oh, yes, I'm great. And, you know, just cut that out. Number four, count your blessings, not your troubles. So important. That's just common sense. Look at that glass half full, not half empty. Number five, do not intimidate others. Do not use force to get your point across. You know, intimidation, as far as this book goes, and this is more centered for, I mean, it's centered for all walks of life because it's important information no matter what, but going into this, don't intimidate people. Don't put yourself on like a high and mighty pedestal where I'm right and bulldoze over them with your opinions. I am guilty of these things, all right? I am definitely 100% guilty because I believe intellectually that I understand things that others may not. And so I have to preach. If I'm going to preach this, I have to live by this and die by this, right? So I've committed all, everything in here I've talked about, I've committed them, okay? No one is perfect. The point is we're going to get better, and we're going to get better, and we're going to get better at communicating and better at dealing with each other on these problems. So, where was I? I'm losing my spot here. Okay, don't intimidate others. So important. Okay, try to profit from your losses. When you lose, when you screw up, when you make mistakes, understand what they were, understand how to correct them, learn for the future. So important. And then the last one, create happiness for others. I mean, if you're talking about the YouTube realm or you're talking about public speaking, what you're really trying to do is not just blast people into dust, okay? What you should be trying to do is actually create a sense of happiness for those around you, a sense of happiness for, you know, the people in your life, the people that you don't even know. If you're doing YouTube videos like I've started doing, I'm not doing them to like, just to, you know, hate on everybody else's ideas. I'm trying to get my ideas out there and exercise free speech in the freest way I know how to. And in doing so, I hope to create happiness for others. That is actually one of my nobler motives. This is not some virtue signaling fest for me. This is not, I don't have ads. I'm doing this as a public service announcement, okay? Because I care about you. I care about you, the viewer. I care about my fellow brothers and sisters all across this country and all across this world. This is this little book, this little golden rule book right here that is free online that I'm going to put the link to below. You don't have to do anything. It's free. The information is just sitting right there, okay? Use it to create happiness for others. There's so many people on YouTube that make me happy when I watch them. They just honestly, they make me happy. And I thank them for that. I thank them for their efforts. And you've inspired me to do the same thing. And I'm in a position that I can actually feel, and through doing these videos, I'm getting better and better, but I actually feel like I can help people. and I want to help them, and I want to help create happiness for them. And I don't want anything for it. I want a better world. I want a better society, okay? It's very near and dear. I'm sorry to get a little clapped here, but it's very near and dear to me, okay? I mean that from the bottom of my heart. So, the perfect way to conquer worry, it's a one-word answer, okay? This is very important, and it doesn't... You see this? Right here. Right there. The perfect way to conquer worry, there's only one word in there. That's it. Pray. And that can also mean meditation for all my brothers and sisters out there who may not believe in a higher power. And that's all it is. I'm not going to go into anything religious, but people throughout the ages, there's no question about it, whether you call it prayer or meditation, you know, shutting off the outside and focusing on, you know, either a higher power or inwards into yourself. Whatever your preference is, pray, okay? You will combat worry with prayer. You know, if I was to put a number two here, I might say something that helps me combat worry or I've gravitated towards is public speaking. You know, that's not in here, but I might put a little sidebar note on there that, you know, me helping conquer my worry and worrying about things that are going on in the world, I pray about them. And I also make these YouTube videos, and both of those things have helped me conquer worry and stress. It's made me better. Like, making these videos, talking directly to the people, and having them truly appreciate what I have to say, giving honest, sincere feedback back to me when they don't even know me and owe me nothing, it means the world to me. So thank you to all you guys. I know this is getting long. We're on the last page, though. I did not expect this to take 40 minutes, but this is critical to my life, and I would like to make it something that's critical to everybody's life. The world can be a better place if we all follow these rules. Okay, enough about that. Sorry about that. I'm in the middle of this, so my phone's now whistling at me and buzzing, and I can't stop it. I got to just get through this, so bear with me. Don't worry about criticism. Kind of important. Number one, remember that unjust criticism is often a disguised compliment. Very true. Yeah, you can probably empathize with that, that sometimes when somebody may backlash or criticize or condemn an idea of yours, it's, I'm going to use this phrase. This is one of my, another classic quote, right? Quotes are so important if you got good ones. Okay, this is one. You only get flack when you're over the target. These World War II bombers, right? You know, if you're just cruising around out in the middle of the ocean, you're not going to get any flack, you know? But when you get above the drop site, you're going to get some resistance. When you hit home, close to home, you're going to get resistance. So remember that unjust criticism is often a disguised compliment. Like, you might be getting close to the truth, and that's why the immediate knee-jerk reaction. You know what I mean? So... another number two for don't worry about criticism is do the very best you can. As long as you do the best you can, critics can fly a kite, all right? They can go somewhere else because you know that you did everything possible that your brain and your heart and your soul could do, okay? So as long as you always pledge to yourself to do the very best that you can in life, you can go ahead and blow that criticism off. Number three, analyze your own mistakes and criticize yourself. You should be, according to this book, and I believe it, the only person you should be criticizing is the one right in the mirror, all right? Because you can't change everybody else, but you can change yourself. So it's very important to self-reflect, okay, and to learn from mistakes. Moving on. This is the next part. I should be showing you all of this, but, you know, right there. I can't read it backwards, but prevent fatigue and worry. Keep your energy and spirits high. All right? Thank you to my buddies who got me the cold brew coffee recipe. There's my Chewbacca Chewbacca cup for the morning.
Cold brew coffee all the way.
Cold brew coffee all the way. I love it. I just made the switch and it's like life changing. So, prevent fatigue and worry and keep your energy high and spirits high. So important, obviously. Rest before you get tired. You will never achieve anything in a state of, I mean, actually, that's not entirely true. I've done, okay? I've stayed up for 2 days working before. You know, just horrific. This is the worst, I never felt worse in my whole life. I did get the job done. It shipped, okay? It was just, it was an absolute nightmare. It was so draining. I feel like I aged a year in one weekend, one time. It was just horrible. So, it's not ideal. Sometimes you just gotta put the pedal to the metal, baby, and get it done, right? I mean, I literally worked from Friday to Sunday and slept for an hour and a half on a concrete floor, okay? So sometimes you just gotta suck it up and get it done, all right? But other times, you know, just make sure you rest. Get rest. Rest. So 6 hours of sleep minimum a night should be your target. Maximum of about 8. That's my personal recommendation. Yours could absolutely be different. Reality is malleable. Don't be an absolutist, all right? But I would suggest, okay, 6 to 8 hours. That's nothing. No real revelation, you know what I mean? Sorry, this video is so long. Get a little refreshment, but okay. So rest. Rest. Rest that mind. Okay. Number two, learn to relax at work. And that doesn't mean go take a nap. It means to be confident in what you're doing at work and you know, have your cup of coffee or whatnot. And if you're following all the other rules, you're feeling all right, you're getting stuff done, you know, don't stress so much. What stress? Okay, let me make a side point. Stress is something, this is not in the book. Okay, I'm gonna close the book for this one. Stress is something that we put on ourselves. Stress is an evolutionary trait, in my opinion, it's a fight or flight type thing, but controlling, like, we don't want to eliminate stress, okay? We do want to eliminate stress, but you're never going to, so the best you can do is control stress. So, that being said, you know, try to control it and relax while you're at work, because even if you're in the middle of a workforce war zone, you know, not real war, but at work, but it's chaotic and crazy going on, you know, learn to be at peace. Again, so many common themes with Star Wars. I don't want to get lost in that, but you know, when you focus in, or the Matrix, I'll switch it up and use the Matrix, where he finally starts to slow down reality. He gets so good at what he's doing. As he becomes the One or whatever, right? He becomes so powerful that he can slow down time, you know? So use that analogy to think about that. When you become so focused and so purpose-driven and oriented, and you get this feeling of you know you're being razor sharp on all of your actions, right? When you do that, you're gonna just naturally start to relax, because you're gonna know that you're gonna have such a high level of confidence that it will overpower and take care of stress inherently by itself. And number three, protect your health and appearance by relaxing at home. That's what you're supposed to do, guys. You know, like, I like to do these videos. It is work. I mean, it's not like backbreaking labor or something like that. It's not tying rebar, but it does take time. It takes a little bit of effort. It takes some brain power, all these sorts of things. So, and because I have a job, I primarily do this at home or in my car or while I'm out and about, those type of things. But every once in a while, you just need to chill. Like, I try, you know, at least one day every 2 or 3 weeks, I try to hang out with a friend of mine and just cut back, unwind. and just have a good time, you know. And I'm not talking about like drugs or alcohol, because I don't believe that that is, you know, necessarily a way to cut back. I mean, I do like to have some drinks from time to time, and I do feel like there's that can help, you know, while you're being social and being friendly with somebody. But you don't want to, you know, just booze it up all the time. That is no good for you, okay? No good for you to do that all the time. Been there, done that. I'll just say that. I'm not going to go into detail, but I've been in my fair share of honky-tonks, all right? All right, so number four. Apply these four good working habits. This is important, okay? A, I'm failing at this currently, the moment I'm talking to you about this, all right? I'm failing at this point. Clear your desk of all papers except those relating to the immediate problem at hand. I'm failing at this on a level that's, I gotta go take care of this. You know what I mean? I even have a couple desks and I still can't. I got papers and stuff everywhere. So again, I by no means am I telling you, because I'm telling you this information, that I'm perfect at it, okay? We all, I don't care, you could be an instructor for the course, okay? You're still a human being. You're still a human being. You're going to fail. This is a guideline. This isn't a mandatory absolutist manual for exactly the proper way to conduct yourself. It's a suggestion. It's something that you yourself can voluntarily graft towards and absorb and make it part of your life, you know? So clear all those papers off your desk, even though mine is full of crap right now. Sorry, I shouldn't say crap. I'm really trying to watch my language. And not because I don't use, you know, harsh language in my real life. I quite frankly, I do. With my friends and things like that, but I'm really trying to reach out to as many people as I can. And I'm not gonna edit that because it shows exactly what I was talking about. I am a human being, okay? And the fact is that I'm trying to become better. I'm trying to use better language. I'm trying to come off as somebody who is educated enough to convey information to you, all right? And so I'm really focusing for, you know, quite frankly, one of the first times in my life, other than business settings, you know, because I watch my language there, but I'm really trying to professionally focus and correct anything and have as powerful of oratory skills as possible, okay? So, not editing that out, and I don't apologize for it. I mean, if you're offended by that word, okay, I'm sorry, but moving on. Do things in the order of importance. Also, that touches back to the compartmentalization. This kind of goes hand in hand, right? If you got all this stuff all over your desk, all right, compartmentalize it. Put it in different piles on another desk so it's not on your actual desk, and then prioritize that. Put those piles in order of how to do them. Again, I'm failing right now. I've got work to do. I can be better, okay? But reading this every day, which is my goal, this is my vow to myself, is before I get going on my day, no matter what I'm doing, I'm gonna wake up every day and I'm gonna read through this. And that goes back to what we were saying earlier, to throw down a challenge. I don't know where it was, but to throw down a challenge, right? I'm telling you on YouTube that my goal is to do this one thing every single day, basically as soon as I get up or as I'm getting my day going, or sometime during the day. I'm gonna do the best I can to try to read this book every day, and that is throwing down a challenge. And I'm making it public, you know? So, you know, I'm gonna do this right now, speaking of it. Right now, and I haven't made any videos or anything or tweet about this, because I don't think that like personal stuff should get in there, but I'm gonna do this specifically for this video. Right now, I weighed in. I've been exercising a lot lately. I've been trying to get in shape a lot. I've been overweight and unhealthy to a certain degree my whole life, okay? And I'm actively, aggressively trying to fix that. And I just weighed in at 287, okay? And I'm gonna also do this as a tribute to Zig Ziglar, because somebody, my father passed me Zig Ziglar tape a long time ago, and he said, you know, how can you be a motivational speaker? How can you go around telling people how to think and act while you're overweight? Because he was overweight at some point, and he started to use his own motivational techniques to become fit. And so I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to throw down a challenge because I'm going to put my money where my mouth is, right? So I weighed in at 287. I am 6'3", 6'4". I'm kind of in that ballpark. And I've weighed as much as 367 pounds about 2 years ago. So I've been doing as good as I can with exercising and dieting. And so I haven't been virtue signaling this the whole time, and nor is this to do that. This is to illustrate that I'm going to throw down a challenge. My goal is to get to 245. I don't even know if my body can do it. I've never been lower than 287. So I just tied my record for the lowest I ever was. But I wasn't fit then. I had basically just stopped eating nutritiously and kind of withered away down to 287, if you will. But now I'm getting fit, you know? I'm not taking any crap. So again, I said that word. Sorry. But my goal is to get to 245. I don't even know if I can do that. Like, if I get as lean and as mean as I can, I mean, I might not be able to get that far. So I'm only doing that as a goal to shoot for. And another quote is, if you shoot for the moon, but maybe you don't quite make it, sometimes you're still in the stars, you know? So another quote. But so when you face a problem, or do things in the order of their importance, and I was getting sidetracked with my challenge, but that's it. I'm putting my money where my mouth is, all right? Like, I'm getting there. I will be 245, all right? Or if I don't get there, I'll be physically fit and as close to 245 as possible. So, in part C, let me recap since that was a kind of a far off thing. So, apply these four good working habits. Clear your desk of all papers except for those relating to the immediate problem at hand. Do the things in order of their importance. When you face a problem, solve it. Then and there. Oh, this is the next part we didn't get to. When you face a problem, solve it then and there if you have the facts necessary to make a decision. So back to the facts thing, you weigh all the facts. And if you have all the facts and you can make a decision, act right then if you know what you're doing. But if you have questions, or you got to still weigh that out, okay? And D, learn to organize, deputize, and supervise, meaning delegation. If you can delegate stuff, again, sorry for the buzzing on the phone. If you can delegate tasks to team members, if you're talking about a business or work or a coalition or an alliance or any sort of people that you're working with, if you're in a position where you can delegate some of that, learn to use that to take care of some of those piles. You know what I mean? Okay, only a couple left. Okay, we're still on preventing fatigue and worry and keeping your energy and spirits high. Okay, so this is two more. Number five, we got to the good working habit. So put enthusiasm into your work. Be happy about it. Treat it like it's fun, like it's as if you're playing a video game or something. You know, just put yourself in that mental mindset where I'm going to go and I'm going to crush my work. I'm going to dominate all these things I have to do with tasks, one after another. I'm going to slay them all, right? And have fun, you know? I like to listen to music. That's just me. I'm a music guy. I'm a musician. I like to play music. So to me, sometimes that'll get me in the mood. Rocking out gets me enthusiastic. You know, hey, little coffee, little cold brew coffee, little music going, little heavy metal maybe. Mm-hmm. Wink, wink. And you'll be on your way, you know. So put enthusiasm into your work. Put enthusiasm in everything you do. All right, all this stuff, mind you, I believe to be completely contagious. Like, the better you are, the more it's going to affect the people around you in a positive, impactful way. Number six, and this is the last thing in the book, interesting. It's the thing that I have the absolute worst, or the absolute, I don't have this issue. But it says, if you do, which is a problem for many, and I realize that. And it's funny that it's in here. Number six is, don't worry about insomnia. Okay? Don't worry about insomnia. So I don't have any sort of insomnia. I don't know, maybe as just a bigger guy and going through maybe some of the stuff I'm going through right now. I just feel beat. At the end of the day, I'm already beat and I'm ready. Sometimes I do find myself like not being able to go to sleep or so involved with what's going on in the world that I'm reading news up late. But anyway, don't worry. Worry is the key word there. Don't worry about insomnia because, you know, quite frankly, try not to worry about a whole lot. Only use that worry and translate it into a battle plan, you know. So, with that being said, wow, clocking in right under an hour, 58 minutes. Did not think it was going to take that long, but this is, quite frankly, the best video I've ever done. I can say that without a shadow of a doubt. The most important and impactful to my fellow man and women on the planet, all right? My fellow men and women on the planet. This right here, this video that I've just done, it's going to make my day much better. I'm going to be a very happy person because I know in my heart that I'm doing the best I can and that I am appealing to nobler motives and that I love my country and I want to love the world and I want to help everybody in the world. And the quickest and easiest thing I know how to do that with is this little book right here. So with that being said, thank you so much for watching my video, guys, and let's change the world, all right? Let's do it.